Hi, welcome to Programmer Space. My name is Desmond. I'm currently a data scientist at Shopee Singapore. And in this video, I'm going to share about the exact resume that I used to land an offer in Shopee as a data scientist. I'll go through the resume in a few sections. I will talk about the good points as well as the areas for improvements. So I'm just sharing a very small part of the many interviews that is currently going on in Shopee. So just take this as a reference for yourself. I hope that this video will be useful to you for your next tech interview at any companies. So my resume is 1.5 pages long, so it's 1.5 page. I think it's generally a good idea to make your resume within perhaps 3 pages and try to pack as many information that are relevant as possible into that resume. So an overall view of the resume is that you can see that it has a good use of space. There are no huge empty spaces. So some resumes that I see has a very big sidebar that are empty. I think that's generally a bad thing to do because it kind of show that you do not have much to show to the recruiter or the interviewer. And as you can see from here as well, the resume is one column. Most of the texts are just in one column because for bigger tech companies, they usually have a HR software that they use to filter out some keywords, and generally one column resumes are the best for this kind of softwares because the text don't get chopped up everywhere. You see, I have the contact information over here, the email, my number, the address, as well as the personal website that I have, my LinkedIn profile, as well as the link to my GitHub. For the education section, I included the CGPA, as well as if you have honors with distinction, it's also a good point to include. Then I would go on to the working and project experiences. Some people like to separate into two sections for this part. So they would have a working experience part and then a project experience part. But personally, I like to put them together because I think they are very similar and they are very, you know, relatable to each other. And you put this in a chronological order, reverse chronological order, sorry. And you start with the most recent one and then you move on to the less recent one and so on. But it's not a must to put it this way. So from what you can see here, actually, I followed this strictly and I think it's kind of messy because like you can see NUS and then Maniland and then University of Malaya, University of Malaya, Maniland again, and back to University of Malaya again because I was strictly following the chronological order. So if I were to redo this again, I might group the organizations together. So I would just have one instance of University of Malaya and then another instance of Maniland. I think this would be less messy. And besides that, I think the description part, the point form over here is less descriptive. So I would recommend the XYZ format where you write the description points in a way that you would say, I accomplish X by Y amount or Y percent by doing Z. So this is generally a good format to follow because it shows that you are results oriented. You know what to do to achieve the necessary results. That over here, I think it's less optimal, where I just basically describe that I conducted research using machine learning models and I did a few teaching assistant jobs, listing out the courses. I think I should actually include more lines per organization. Yeah, you should definitely put one or two accomplishments that you are most proud of while you are at that organization. And also, I should have used better words such as spearheaded or manage a team of X people and so on. And then move on to the activities and awards because I was still considered a fresh graduate. So I think the activities and awards that I have in university are still relevant to this job application. So I have 3 sections over here. The award highlights, where I put the national level, university level competitions that I've joined and won. The international exchange exposure, where I go to different universities and attend their summer programs or semester break programs. And then in the end, I have community service, where I volunteer for several events or workshops. So let's talk about the awards section. I think for this section, it's very useful to put the national level if you have the competitions, programming competitions if it's if it's available to put it over here, and then list which place you got. This kind of gives the interviewer an evidence that you are actually considered top programmers in that level. For the competitions that are well known, for example like ACM, ICPC, it's okay to just put the name over there. But for competitions that are new, for example this CIMB Bank 3D Conquest, I put a additional one line description to tell about what is the competition about, what did I do, and so on. And so I rank this according to the most important ones. So I started with national level and I move on to university level, and then I share about the other competitive programming competitions that are, you know, less well known. And I actually put a link over here which points to the official website that shows the ranking. So yeah, I think competitions are very helpful for you to get an entry-level job as a fresh graduate. So moving on to the next section, which is the international exchange and exposure. So for this part, it mainly shows that you are a very active student while you are in university and try to get as many exposure as possible. So over here, I listed a few universities that I went to. So the first one is actually at the University of Indonesia, and then the second one at Tsinghua University in Beijing. And then the third one is a NVIDIA AI conference that I go to. And then the fourth one is Telkom University, also at Indonesia. And for the first one, it's actually a Southeast Asia machine learning school. I think it's very relevant because the job that I applied for in Shopee is actually data scientist, and data scientists usually do machine learning work. So I kind of added a one-liner over here to talk about the things that I learned during that summer exchange, during the machine learning summer school. So I said attended 1 week lectures and tutorials from Google, DeepMind, Facebook, NUS, NTU, etc. And then for Tsinghua University, it's also a deep learning summer school. I think I should actually include more about the courses that I attend, like deep learning, neural networks, and so on. And then for the NVIDIA AI conference, I attended as a teaching assistant and a participant. I think this is actually less relevant because I didn't actually publish any paper at the conference. So. And for Telkom University, this is less relevant as well, but I just put over here. Actually, for this part, what I would advise myself to do is to actually add a point where I'm actually selected to join these programs out of how many participants. Move on to the community service section. So this part, I included the activities and workshops that I joined or organized during my university. So I actually did a Python workshop with a few of my seniors back in university, and we did this for free. I think it's a very good point to be in the resume, so I included it. And the next one is I was the program director of Programming League. I think it's relevant as well because it's programming once again. So I said that I hosted the competition in faculty to encourage students to come and join this competition to improve their programming skills and so on. And then I also included another achievement, which is besides managing the whole project, I also found 4 industry sponsors of my own to fund this competition. Next is the head of human resource for a fundraising event. And then coming up next is like the hackathon mentor for the AI hackathon that I am a committee of. And then at the end, I have the spoken languages, because like I'm actually applying for a tech company inside ASEAN region. So Southeast Asia region, we have a lot of different cultures, languages and all that. So if you are bilingual, trilingual, or even know 4 languages, it's always a good bonus point to put the languages that you know over here. I think it's a small plus point. It's not a very big plus point, but it's very good to have. There are a few points that I want to add on as well. So like for this activities and awards section, you can see that there are a lot of empty spaces actually. So what I might do next time, or like for my newer resumes, is to actually make some changes to the alignment where the indentation is not that much. So perhaps I can move this part to the left a bit, and then this part to the left a bit. And also, things to keep in mind is that think of this resume as an elevator pitch where you only have maybe 10 seconds or 30 seconds to impress the recruiter. So people read from the top to bottom. So make sure that you put the most impressive thing you have at the very top and maybe the very left as well. so people read from top to bottom and left to right. You should also bold whatever that's necessary, and also try to use a font that is commonly known, like Times New Roman. Try not to use some fancy fonts, because sometimes the computer just couldn't read, and it might be a mess. And I'll also include some links somewhere in the video that these are some resources that you should definitely check out. So you could also Google or YouTube, Google resumes or Facebook resumes, then people would also share about their resumes that you can check out. I think those resources definitely helped me to improve my resume. Yeah, you can also ask a senior or someone in the company that you want to apply for to have a look at your resume and tell you what are the things that you need to improve on. And yeah, for more information, if you would like to know more about my interview experience at Shopee, I would also put a link in the description below or somewhere here. Because I've actually written an article on Medium which talked about my entire interview experience, from getting the recruiter's call, the coding interview, to the manager's interview, and then at the very end, landing an offer at Shopee. Thanks for watching. If you think this is helpful, you know what to do to make YouTube recommend my videos to you in the future. All the best in your next job hunting. Also, let me know what are the content that you like me to share in the future videos. Okay, thanks. Bye-bye.